Praise God again. My name is Purity Wambogesho. I'm 9 years old and I have a memory verse. Genesis chapter 8 verse 22, it says, as long as the earth endures, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night will never cease. Thank you.
Praise God again. My name is Grace Nyambura and I have a memory verse from the book of Genesis chapter 8 verse 22. It says, as long as the earth endures, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night will never cease.
Good morning, wonderful children of God. How are you? How was your week? My name is Teacher Irene. I'm born again. I love Christ as my personal savior. And my week was so blessed. And today I'm actually very, very excited to take you through the lesson for today. So if you have your notebook and your pen, please take it now and note what we'll read today. So our lesson today is called God Keeps His Promise. Do you know what is a promise? Have you ever promised someone something? So let me just tell you what is a promise. A promise is an assurance something will happen or someone will give you something. For example, imagine you are left at home and your mom, your guardian, your uncle, your auntie, or even your brother told you, when you stay in the house, you finish your homework, I will bring for you a gift. That is a promise. And then in the evening, as they come home, they come with a gift. How will you feel? How will you feel if they keep that promise? Isn't it a good feeling? Or even you were in school and then you are told, if you perform very well, I will give you a gift. And then at the end of the term, you pass very well. And then you brought a gift. Wow. And happens to be your favorite toy. Just like this. How will you feel? How will you make it feel? So today we'll actually be studying about how God keeps promise. One more question. Have you told someone to keep a promise and they forgot? How did you feel? For example, maybe you trusted your very close friend to keep a secret for you, and then they did not keep the secret. They promised to keep it, but they did not keep it. How did you feel? Did you feel angry? Did you feel disappointed? I know for sure you're disappointed. But guess what? Today we'll be studying about God who cannot disappoint in keeping his promise. So take your notebook and write today's reading. It will be from the book of Genesis chapter 8 from verse 1 to 22 and also Genesis chapter 9 from verse 1 to 13. So I remember last week, Teacher Susan took us through the Noah's Ark, how animals went in two by two, and they were locked inside together with Noah's family. So today I'll be handling what happened after that. So after that, it rained and rained for around 150 days. And then after that, that's when the water stopped raining and it started going down, decreasing. And after the rain decreased, Noah opened a window. Yes, you're wondering whether the ark had a window. Yes, Noah had built a window. And when Noah saw that the water had decreased, he sent a dove. You know what is a dove? Some of you know it as douche. So he sent a dove to go outside, and when the dove went out, it came back because it did not see a tree to land on. So Noah waited for another 7 days and sent again the dove. When they went with the when the dove went and came back, in its beak there was an olive leaf, like there was an olive leaf. That's when Noah knew that the plants have started growing again. He gave more 7 days, and that's when he sent a dove, but the dove never came back, meaning it had branches to land on. So Noah was very excited, and he knew it's right about time to open the ark. So he went ahead and opened the ark. But before he opened the ark, actually God spoke to him. Yes, God spoke to Noah. He told him, you can now come out with your family and all the animals that were inside the ark. So after that, Noah was very impressed with God. He went and built an altar and made a sacrifice with one of the best animals that were there, and God was very, very, very happy with him, and he said, never again will I curse the earth and destroy the living creatures with floods. Wow, imagine God saying never again. Does that sound amazing? Wow. So God blessed Noah and his family, and he said, increase in numbers and fill the earth. And even he said that everything that lives in the earth will be food as long as we don't eat them alive. Imagine, that's why we can eat cows, we can eat goats, we can eat meat from chicken, because God said so. He even gave us food. And at that point, he established a covenant with Noah and the descendants, and we are the descendants of Noah, and that's why he also keeps the covenant with us. So, and he gave a sign. Do you know what is a sign? It's something to remind you of that promise. So he gave a sign of a rainbow. Today I came up with a picture of a rainbow that shows the sign that God gave to Noah. So do you remember the last time it rained and there were wonderful colors in the sky, like red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and purple? And still there were some small droplets of rain still falling, and then the sun just appears, and then where there's still clouds. Yes, that is a reminder that God keeps his promise. So in the book of Genesis chapter 9 verse 13, he says, I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be a sign of my covenant between me and you. So every time you see the rainbow, just know that God keeps his promise. And the reason why God keeps his promise is because he loves me and you. So every time you see the rainbow, know that God keeps his promise. Why? Because he loves me and you. So as we come to the end of our today's lesson, I will tell you, if you have colors in the house, you have your crayons, just go and try and make a rainbow. After you make a rainbow, show to your sister, to your mother, to your dad, to your guardian, to your auntie, or whoever you are with at home, and you can stick it next to your bed to keep on reminding you that God keeps his promise. So I will ask just two questions that you'll either answer to whoever you are watching with, and so that you can know whether you've learned something for today. Question number one, what was the sign of covenant between Noah and God? Question number two, what did God promise Noah? So as we come to the end of the lesson, I would like us to do a memory verse together. So you can write down. Our memory verse comes from the book of Genesis chapter 8 verse 22. It says, as long as the earth endures, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night will never cease. So we will memorize together once more. Genesis chapter 8 verse 22, it says, as long as the earth endures, seed time and harvest time, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night will never cease. So let's make sure we practice that by Bible verse, and by our next lesson you'll be remembering what we learned today. So we've come to the end of our lesson. It has been amazing time to teach you, and I pray that you're blessed. So let's just close our eyes and pray. Father, thank you for your great in our lives. Thank you for the promise. Thank you even for the sign of the promise. And thank you because we know you're faithful, you always keep it. We pray that, Father, that you'll help us to always keep our promise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. Bye-bye.
After creation, after Adam and Eve, and after Cain and Abel, more people started to populate the earth. The more people there were, the worse things got. Adam and Eve had sinned, and now everyone was born sinful. People became wicked and evil, and soon forgot about God. There was at least one family who followed God's way: Noah, his wife, and their three sons. They were faithful to God. They served God. One day, God spoke to Noah and gave him an incredible task. God told Noah that he would punish the world because of its sin and send a great flood that would cover the entire earth. God told Noah that he would spare him and his family, and that Noah should build a big boat called an ark. God told them exactly how to make it. They were to leave room for themselves, as well as a lot of animals from all over the earth. They began construction on the ark right away. It was hard work. They had to do it all by themselves, and it was a huge boat, hundreds of feet long. The people thought Noah was crazy. They laughed and made fun of him. But Noah preached to them and told them to repent of their sins and obey God. The ark was almost done. As Noah and his sons put the finishing touches on it, the people continued in their wicked ways and paid no attention to God's warning. When the time came and the ark was complete, God sent two kinds of every animal in existence to the ark. That was incredible. Noah and his family, as well as all their animals, were to stay on this big boat until the flood was over. Two kinds of every animal had a place on the ark. Two by two, they got onto the ark. Giraffes, elephants, lions, kitty cats, turtles, worms, bears, birds, and everything else. And then the flood came. As the first sprinkles of rain splashed onto the ground, the people knew they were doomed. The ark's door was closed, and Noah and his family were safe. Huge fountains underneath the earth opened, and a torrent of rain gushed from the sky. Puddles grew into ponds. Streams formed into rivers. Rivers roared into the lakes. The lakes rose, connecting to form an ocean that covered the whole world. Everything was underwater. All the people who rejected God and made fun of Noah were dead. Only Noah's little family and his floating zoo were alive. They sailed on the vast ocean for many months as rain kept falling. Then the rain suddenly stopped. Noah sent out a bird to see if it could find a tree or some place to land, but the bird came back. Many days later, Noah sent out a dove. The dove returned with a leaf. This told Noah that the water had gone down and trees were starting to appear. Eventually, the ark came to rest on a mountainside. The flood was over. It was time to open the doors and let the animals out. As the doors opened, the birds fluttered out in freedom. The animals stepped onto the firm ground and went to find their way in the new world. Noah and his family stepped out, and breathed a sigh of thankfulness to God. The first thing that Noah and his family did was to make an altar to God. They sacrificed to him and thanked him for protecting their family through the flood. God made a covenant with Noah. Then they saw it. A huge rainbow spread across the sky, painted in the most brilliant and beautiful colors that they had ever seen. It was a promise from God. A promise that he would never again curse the earth and destroy all living things with a flood.